You can do from standing up, and or you can do when the guy just have the knee up on the floor. So we can do from like when the person is here, outside, or you can do from when he's standing up. So you pick the way that you prefer. So we're gonna, I'm gonna continue what Daniel did. So we're gonna stay with the Shiloh team. I like this book a lot. Just a few details that I'm gonna talk. I like to talk about this work. Number one, if you're gonna work this work, make sure your foot is always live like that. So don't allow your foot to go with all the violent in the foot. So don't allow that happen. Why? Someone that is really used to this work, as soon as you do this, he's gonna slide the foot out this ground. So when you have the, a little more, it's a little harder for him. So make sure that foot stay alive. That helps a lot. Number two, this knee, when you do it, make sure you keep your knee outside. It's another thing that helps a lot. Can you guys see what I'm doing?
Of course you are, right?
Of course you are. So make sure, like, your leg, your knee, I don't like to keep my knee closer to his knee. I like to open a little more wider than his knee. And I mean, just gonna give a couple details how I do. See his knee, again, I like to give him one option only. So what I do exactly, I pull more towards my chest, always going that way. So I don't pull this way because now, like say, I have both the options. He has there and he has here. So I kind of direct him more in that way. So usually when you get like the knee, you start to work through here, get the shin, he's gonna base, he feels he's gonna start to work in his base. I like to catch his hand a lot, in OB. So, but the detail is, every time I catch, I don't pull to me. I don't pull to me, I punch against him. So when I go in, sometimes his hands come on me, sometimes he touches me. So like the movement, it's here, here. From here, you start to have the option. See how he bends on the floor? Remember I told you guys, that's gonna happen. I know that hands come on the floor. The reason that I punch it, the reason that I punch against him is if I pull, he's gonna start circling his hands with me. When I push against his own body, I lock that off. So it's hard for him to circle that hand. If I stay here forever, of course, he's gonna get out. So from here, what are you looking to do? Remember I said about the hook? We're gonna kick him that way. So I'm kicking, like I say, that way. Get up on the leg, and we're gonna single leg. So again, number one, two, oh, by the way, I always lock this foot back here. So I just don't go to the hook here, my foot is always locking his foot. Why? If anything goes wrong when I pull him, I push his back. And he's back on my half guard. So I forgot the detail. Actually, we'll talk about that then, right? So it's go one, two. And then the move is the same. So when I start to move, I know he's gonna go, push. I'm right here. If I feel like he's coming back strong, like towards me and losing, look at my legs, stretched out. And then you have the options to go to his, I don't want to talk, it's going to be too much. Okay? forget that one, I'm sorry. So one, hold, down, push against the head. I'm going to give the kick, away, hands here. Now we're going to turn, we're going to see the left. Got it?
Deco, just real quick, you locked the hands before you went to your back. I just don't, I know people are going to go like this, and then they're going to try to get the hands.
No, it's something comes together.
Hand first.
Yeah, usually like when I get here, usually that's when I start to work the hands, like you start to catch me, and that's when I go. And then I kick, that's the kick. I mean, when you kick here, I mean, I'm going up here, but you can kick, go after the other leg. I mean, from there, you just have to get up.